were solitary as we did create you at the first. And ye have left behind you all that we bestowed upon you. And we behold not with you those your intercessors, of whom ye claimed that they possessed a share in you. Now is the bond between you severed, and that which ye presumed hath failed you. Lo, Allah it is who splitteth the grain of corn and the date stone for sprouting. He bringeth forth the living from the dead, and is the bringer forth of the dead from the living. Such is Allah. How then are ye perverted? He is the cleaver of the daybreak, and he hath appointed the night for stillness, and the sun and the moon for reckoning. That is the measuring of the mighty, the wise. And he it is who hath set for you the stars, that ye may guide your course by them amid the darkness of the land and the sea. We have detailed our revelations for a people who have knowledge. And he it is who hath produced you from a single being, and hath given you a habitation and a repository. We have detailed our revelations for a people who have understanding. He it is who sendeth down water from the sky, and therewith we bring forth buds of every kind. We bring forth the green blade, from which we bring forth the thick clustered grain. And from the date palm, from the pollen thereof, spring pendant bunches. And we bring forth gardens of grapes, and the olive and the pomegranate, alike and unalike. Look upon the fruit thereof, when they bear fruit, and upon its ripening. Lo, herein verily are portents for a people who believe. Yet they ascribe as partners unto him the jinn, although he did create them, and impute falsely, without knowledge, sons and daughters unto him. Glorified be he and high exalted above all that they ascribe unto him. The originator of the heavens and the earth, how can he have a child, when there is for him no consort, when he created all things and is aware of all things? Such is Allah, your Lord. There is no God save him, the creator of all things. So worship him, and he taketh care of all things. Vision comprehendeth him not, but he comprehendeth all vision. He is the subtile, the aware. Proofs have come unto you from your Lord, so whoso seeth, it is for his own good, and whoso is blind to his own hurt, and I am not a keeper over you. Thus do we display our revelations, that they may say unto thee, Muhammad, thou hast studied, and that we may make it clear for people who have knowledge. Follow that which is inspired in thee from thy Lord. There is no God save him, and turn away from the idolaters. Had Allah willed, they had not been idolatrous. We have not set thee as a keeper over them, nor art thou responsible for them. Revile not those unto whom they pray beside Allah, lest they wrongfully revile Allah through ignorance. Thus unto every nation have we made their deed seem fair. Then unto their Lord is their return, and he will tell them what they used to do. And they swear a solemn oath by Allah, that if there come unto them a portent, they will believe therein. Say, portents are with Allah, and so is that which telleth you, that if such came unto them, they would not believe. We confound their hearts and their eyes, as they believed not therein at the first. We let them wander blindly on in their contumacy. And though we should send down the angels unto them, and the dead should speak unto them, and we should gather against them all things in array, they would not believe unless Allah so willed. Howbeit, most of them are ignorant. Thus have we appointed unto every prophet an adversary, devils of humankind and jinn, who inspire in one another plausible discourse, through guile. If thy Lord willed, they would not do so. So leave them alone with their devising, that the hearts of those who believe not in the hereafter may incline thereto, and that they may take pleasure therein, and that they may earn what they are earning. Shall I seek other than Allah for judge when he it is who hath revealed unto you this scripture fully explained? Those unto whom we gave the scripture aforetime know that it is revealed from thy Lord in truth. So be not thou, O Muhammad, of the waverers. Perfected is the word of thy Lord in truth and justice. There is naught that can change his words. He is the hearer, the knower. If thou obeyedst most of those on earth, they would mislead thee far from Allah's way. They follow naught but an opinion, and they do but guess. Lo, thy Lord, he knoweth best who erreth from his way, and he knowest best who are the rightly guided. Eat of that over which the name of Allah hath been mentioned, if ye are believers in his revelations. How should ye not eat of that over which the name of Allah hath been mentioned, when he hath explained unto you that which is forbidden unto you, unless ye are compelled thereto? But lo, many are led astray by their own lusts through ignorance. Lo, thy Lord, he is best aware of the transgressors. Forsake the outwardness of sin and the inwardness thereof. Lo, those who garner sin will be awarded that which they have earned. And eat not of that whereon Allah's name hath not been mentioned, for lo, it is abomination. Lo, the devils do inspire their minions to dispute with you, but if ye obey them, ye will be in truth as idolaters. Is he who was dead, and we have raised him unto life, and set for him a light wherein he walketh among men, as him whose similitude is in utter darkness, whence he cannot emerge? Thus is their conduct made fair seeming for the disbelievers. And thus have we made in every city great ones of its wicked ones, that they should plot therein. They do but plot against themselves, though they perceive not. And when a token cometh unto them, they say, We will not believe till we are given that which Allah's messengers are given. Allah knoweth best with whom to place his message. Humiliation from Allah and heavy punishment will smite the guilty for their scheming. And whomsoever it is Allah's will to guide, he expandeth his bosom unto the surrender. And whomsoever it is his will to send astray, he maketh his bosom close and narrow, as if he were engaged in sheer ascent. Thus Allah layeth ignominy upon those who believe not. This is the path of thy Lord, a straight path. We have detailed our revelations for a people who take heed. For them is the abode of peace with their Lord. He will be their protecting friend because of what they used to do. In the day when he will gather them together, he will say, O ye assembly of the jinn, many of humankind did ye seduce, and their adherents among humankind will say, Our Lord, we enjoyed one another, but now we have arrived at the appointed term which thou appointedst for us. He will say, Fire is your home. Abide therein forever, save him whom Allah willeth to deliver. Lo, thy Lord is wise, aware. Thus we let some of the wrongdoers have power over others because of what they are wont to earn. O ye assembly of the jinn and humankind, came there not unto you messengers of your own who recounted unto you my tokens and warned you of the meeting of this your day? They will say, We testify against ourselves, and the life of the world beguiled them, and they testify against themselves that they were disbelievers. This is because thy Lord destroyeth not the townships arbitrarily while their people are unconscious of the wrong they do. For all there will be ranks from what they did, thy Lord is not unaware of what they do.